Have you ever seen hand-stitched tapestries mistaken as paintings or even embroidery?
What's visible immediately is that I'm working with African-American models. There are not enough, even at this late stage, there aren't enough African-American images, positive ones, out in public media. And art is a form of media. The size I work in is unusual for embroiderers. Because embroidery takes such a long time, it's a slow process.
Ruth Miller is very talented. Each piece of work just tells a story. I couldn't believe she used yarn and thread. I thought they were used with something else.
I think anything can be learned. And that's one of the things that I wanted to show in this exhibition. Most people see my art as being so technically difficult that they could never do it. I want them to see that anything can be done. Any type of creativity is a step-by-step decision on top of another small decision until a finished, hopefully masterpiece, arises. I want you to see this show not just as an art exhibition, but as another window on another way of looking at politics. I think politics starts small one-to-one relationships. A country is a collection of one-to-one interactions. Most people try to say whatever they're saying in a few inches by a few inches. And whereas I'm working really larger than life sometimes. When I went to museums, I didn't get a chance to see how the artist created what he did and what types of decisions he made during the process of making the art. In this case, I have put my whole process out there for the community, for the art lover, for the artist, for the would-be artist, for the child who's interested in art, or even more important, those people who were not interested. I want people to be encouraged by that and to try things that seem like they'd be too hard to do, but once, if they just took it step by step, they'd find that they were able to accomplish it. Come see for that reason. This piece is about the fact that sometimes we try to get involved with people or situations that don't accept us. For whatever reason, not that they're bad people or overly harsh, but it's just not a good fit for us. And we're not successful in becoming a part of them. So this piece talks about the fact that when we're forced to fall back on ourselves because we're all we have.
Sure, everybody wants to know who's that beautiful man. So that's usually it. And they're waiting for the backstory, but they're not getting it. The impossible dream is the gateway to self-love. Usually, when we seek relationships with other people, it's so that we can find ourselves in their eyes. When it's not possible, when the relationship doesn't work, for some reason, the person doesn't accept us, or we don't feel comfortable in it, we're forced to fall back on our own resources. We're forced to look within ourselves and find something that we like about ourselves. Find some way to have self-esteem on our own rather than borrowing it from the esteem of other people. I have taught people who have told me, well, I can't draw a straight line. And, you know, I have shown them that, yes, indeed, they can. And what I teach them is how to take the mistakes out. Once you take the mistakes out, then the beautiful piece that you intended all along is right there. I would like to be remembered as someone who tried to remove any self-imposed limits on herself. Someone who never gave up trying to be a better person or a stronger person. If people 100 years from now admire the art, well, I would appreciate that. But in a real sense, I think God is the artist all the time. art is, it's the God in me that creates the art. It's the God in writers who writes the books. It's never just us, because we get inspiration from where we don't know. So that where we don't know part, we can't take credit for.
Whether this is your first time visiting a museum, or if you just want to experience something new, come on out to the Orr O'Keeffe Museum of Art in Biloxi Tuesday through Saturday from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. to see Thinking Art into Being by Ruth Miller.